Hello friends, today we will discuss problems on accounting standard 4, that is contingencies and events occurring after the balance sheet date, right? All these problems have been taken from ICA practice manual, so we will go one by one. Come to question number 1. Question number 1, you are an accountant preparing accounts of A Limited as on 31st of March 2011. After year end, the following events have taken place in April 2011. That is, they are referring to events occurring after the balance sheet, right? Yeah, first one, a fire broke out in the premises damaging uninsured stock worth how much? 10 lakhs. Salvage value is how much? 2 lakhs. So in this case, if you observe, this should be an event which is a non-adjusting event. Why non-adjusting event? Why? Because this event will not take any going concern of the entity. Point one. Point number 2, a suit against the company advertisement was filed by a party claiming damages of 20 lakhs. If a suit is filed against the company claiming a damage of rupees 20 lakhs, no, we need to ask the management whether this situation was there on the balance sheet date. If yes, this could become an adjusting event. If no, then this will become what? A non-adjusting event, right? So according to me, even this event is also taken as what? Non-adjusting event. Let's see what your ICA answer refers. Hence, fire accident on loss there must not be disclosed as a fact that the right. Hence, fire accident and loss thereof must be disclosed. And also the fact that the stock of the company are uninsured with the value of what's the future risk if possible. So if you still observe, it's only a disclosing event, but it is not taken as what? Adjusting event. Likewise, second case, if you observe, suit filed against the company being a contingent liability must be disclosed. Again, this is also what event? A disclosing event only. See, when disclosure becomes mandatory, disclosure becomes mandatory when the event is what? A material event. If the management feels that these events are not material event, then even disclosure is also not required. So in both the cases, both are what's a non-adjusting event, but no doubt, what type of event? Disclosing events, right? Chalo, I'm going to question number 2. Question number 2 le lete hain. Come to question number 2. MEC Limited could not recover an amount of 8 lakhs from a debtor. The company is aware that the debtor is in great financial risk. I think this is a clue to your question. If the debtor is already in great financial risk, the company should have created by this time a full provision. The accounts of the company for the year ended 31st March 2011 were finalized by making a provision at the rate of 25% of the amount due from the debtor. In May 2011, the debtor became bankrupt and nothing is recoverable from him. Okay, superb. Do you advise the company to provide for entire loss of 8 lakhs in books of accounts for the year ended 31st March 2011? See, in this case, if you still observe, the management was aware that the debtor is in great financial risk, so they should have already prepared 100% provision. So this type of event is said to be what event? Adjusting event. Why adjusting event? The information was there on the balance sheet date, but before the books of accounts are finalized, the management got additional information. Thereby, this event will become what event? Adjusting event, right? So you can see your ICA answer once by pausing the video. Right. Therefore, if you see the answer, the company is advised to provide for what, sir? Amount of 8 lakhs in the books of accounts for the year ended 31st March 2011. So obviously, this type of events are said to be what event? Adjusting event. Can we take the next question? Next. A major fire has damaged the assets, sir, in a factory of a limited company on 5th April, 5 days after the year end and closure of accounts. Okay, the loss is estimated at 10 crores, out of which 7 crores will be recoverable from the insurance company. If you observe, the loss is of 10 crores, out of which 7 crores could be recovered. Thereby, it is very clear that going concern will not be affected. Continue. Explain briefly how the loss should be treated in the final accounts for the previous year. See, if you carefully observe, this should become an example of what, non-adjusting event. No doubt, though it's a non-adjusting event, we should make a disclosure. Why non-adjusting event? Because there was no such event on the balance sheet date, that's point one. Point number two, taking case number two, going concern is also not getting affected. When going concern is not getting affected, when the event was not there on the balance sheet date, these type of events are said to be what's a non-adjusting event. But seeing the size of the loss, if the management feels that the loss is material, they can make a disclosure. Let's see your IC answer. Yeah, IC answer says it's sufficient if you make a disclosure of the event. So adjustment of loss is not required. Let there be a stock, you should make only a disclosure in this case. I'm going to question number four. Question number four. A company entered into an agreement to sell its immobile property to another company for rupees 30 lakhs. Already agreement to sell is already entered. Okay. The company, the property was shown in the balance sheet at 7 lakhs. The agreement to sell was concluded on 15 February 2011 and the sale deeds were registered on 30th April 2011. So 15 February ko agreement for sale ho gaya aur sale deed kab ban gayi 30th of April ko. You are required to state with reasons how this event would be dealt within the financial statements for the year ended 31st March 2011. So if you carefully observe, this should become obviously an adjusting event. Why adjusting event? I'll tell you. Because agreement was sale was already entered on or before 31st of March. Only thing is the sale deed was completely registered with the other party only on 30th of April. Thereby this type of event should be taken as what, sir? Adjusting event. That's point number one. Point number two, if I'm not wrong, there is a profit or loss. Book value is given. I think book value is not given. The sale value is how much, sir? The sale value is 35 lakhs. But whereas book value is how much, sir? 7 lakhs. Therefore, you can make a profit booking of how much, 28 lakhs ka profit booking kar lo. Thereby, this type of events are said to be what type of event? Adjusting event. You can read the IC answer. This is clearly an event occurring after the balance sheet date, but agreement to sale was effected on 15th April. Therefore, adjustment to the asset sale is necessary. Thereby, this event is said to be what type of event? Adjusting event. आपको क्या करना पड़ेगा इस केस में, बिकॉज अग्रीमेंट टू सेल वॉज ऑलरेडी एंटर्ड बिफोर 31st ऑफ मार्च, राइट ना? देर बाई द सेल कम्स टू कम्प्लीट आफ्टर 31st ऑफ मार्च, दिस बिकम्स वॉट इवेंट? एडजस्टिंग इवेंट. वाई? देर वॉज सम इवेंट ऑन और बिफोर द बैलेंस शीट डेट, देर बाई दिस इवेंट इज सेट टू बी वॉट इवेंट? एडजस्टिंग इवेंट, राइट? आगे चलते हैं. कम टू क्वेश्चन नंबर फाइव. In Raj Company Limited, theft of cash of 2 lakhs by the cashier in January 2011 was detected in May 2011. The accounts of the company were not yet approved by the board of directors of the company. Ye theft ka case hai. There is a theft of cash of rupees how much, sir? 2 lakhs. Very good. The theft happened in the month of January 2011 itself. But this was detected by the management only in the month of what? May 2011. The accounts of the company were not yet approved by the board of directors of the company. Whether the theft of cash has to be adjusted in the accounts of the company for the year ended 31st March 2011. If I am not wrong, even this should be taken as what, adjusting event. I'll tell you why. Why? Because if I am not wrong, when they would have done physical verification of cash on 31st of March, the cash balance as per books and the physical cash balance would not have been tallied. So information was there on the balance sheet date. Only thing is the recovery was made after 31st of March. So this should become what type of event? This should become adjusting event. So let's see your IC answer. Therefore, it is necessary to make the necessary adjustment in the financial statements of the company for the year ended 31st March 2011. Thereby, as per your IC, even this is taken as what event? Adjusting event. Why adjusting? 31st March ko jab cash count kiya hoga, physical cash balance and book balance would not have been tallied. Thereby the management is aware that there is a cash theft as on 31st of March. So thereby this becomes what type of event? Adjusting event, right? Chalta hum. Question number 6 mein jaate hum log. Let's see question number 6. A company follows April to March as its financial year. The company recognizes checks dated 31st March or before received from customers after balance sheet date but before approval of financial statement by debiting checks in hand account and crediting debtors account. Okay, kya bola hai? See, they are telling that the whatever the company receives a check which are dated prior to 31st of March, right? No doubt, even if they are received after 31st of March, the company writes an entry called nothing but checks in hand account debit TO to what account? debtors account credit. I'll read the whole sum for you. A company follows April to March as its financial year. The company recognizes checks dated 31st March or before received from customers after balance sheet date but before approval of financial statements by debiting checks in hand account and crediting debtors account. Upar jo entry boli hai, ye entry pass kar deti hai company. The checks in hand is shown in the balance sheet as an item of cash and cash equivalent. Okay. The checks in hand are presented by the bank in the month of April and are also realized in the same month in the normal course after depositing into bank. State with reasons whether the collection of checks bearing dated 31st March or before, bearing 31st of March or before, but received after the balance sheet date is an adjusting event and how this fact is to be disclosed by the company. I'll just request you pause this video and just once you can read the sum once. Ek bar padh lo, acha important sum hai. Kya ho kya raha hai? Jo debtor se check kar rahe hain, wo kab aa rahe hain? 31st March ke baad aa rahe hain. Par books of accounts finalize hone ke pehle hi aa ja rahe hain. Us check ke upar agar hum log date dekhein, to date kya hai? 31st March aur uske pehle ki date hai. To company abhi tak kya rule follow kar rahi hai? Company jo bhi checks aa rahe hain before finalizing books of accounts, they are writing the entry called checks in hand account debitor, TO to what account? TO to debtors account. तभी क्या पूछना चाहता है? State with reasons whether the collection of checks bearing dated 31st March or before, but received after balance sheet date is an adjusting event, and how this fact is to be disclosed by the company. Right. अब एक बार सोचो आप लोग, क्या 31st March को information available था that the check is being received, whether the company was aware on 31st of March or at least on or before 31st of March that the checks are in transit? No, right? If the checks are not in transit or even if they are transit and the company is not aware of it, then the company should have recorded this collection in the month of April, not in the month of March. So according to me, this event should be what type of event? This should be a non-adjusting event. क्यों non-adjusting event है? Because checks received information was not available with the company on or before 31st of March. Receiving checks after 31st of March happens in the normal course of business. Therefore, you should recognize this as a collection in the month of what? April. Thereby, debtors should be shown as debtors as on 31st of March. And collection from them should be shown in the month of what? April. So thereby, according to me, this should become what type of event? It should become non-adjusting event. Let's see what is your IC answer. Yeah, your IC supports the answer saying that it is not a adjusting event. So therefore, the accounting treatment followed by the company is what, sir? This is a wrong accounting treatment. The company is not advised to do this treatment. Thereby, data should be shown properly and checks collected should be shown in the month of April but not on the balance sheet date on 31st of March. Am I clear? So this is a good sum. You can write here important. Okay. Chalo, pause karke hona hai toh dekh lo video. Come to question number 7. Yeah, come to question number 7. While preparing its final accounts for the year ended 31st March 2010, a company made a provision for doubtful debt at the rate of 4% of its total debtors as per trend followed by the company from the previous years. Theek hai? Now the normal course mein 4% ka provision bana diya hai. In the first week of March 2010, kaun se week mein? First week of March 2010, a debtor for rupees 3 lakhs has suffered heavy loss due to an earthquake. The loss was not covered by any insurance policy. अपने डेटार को इतना ह्यूज लॉस हो गया है. द कंपनी वॉज अवेयर ऑफ दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन 31st ऑफ मार्च. कंटिन्यू. इन अप्रैल 2010 द डेटार बिकम व्हाट, सर? बैंकक्रप्ट. कैन द कंपनी प्रोवाइड फॉर फुल लॉस अराइजिंग आउट ऑफ इंसॉल्वेंसी ऑफ द डेटार इन द फाइनल अकाउंट्स फॉर द ईयर एंडेड 31st March 2010? अब वो क्वेश्चन क्या है? कैन द कंपनी प्रोवाइड फॉर द 100% प्रोविजन ऑन द डाउटफुल डेट? The answer is obviously yes. This will become what type of event? This will become adjusting event, because the company is already aware that the debtor, the amount may not be recoverable from the debtor. Thereby, the event is said to be what event? Adjusting event. The company is supposed to create 100% provision on this bad debt, right? Dekh lo ek bar aap log answer. Yeah, accordingly, full provision of bad debt amounting to 3 lakh should be made to cover the loss arising from the debtor. Thereby, this event is said to be what type of event? Adjusting event ban jayega ye. Am I clear? क्यों बोलते 31st मार्च को कंपनी को ऑलरेडी इन्फॉर्मेशन अवेलेबल है दैट द डेटर हैज सफर्ड ह्यूज लॉस देयर बाय दिस इवेंट इज सेड टू बी व्हाट इवेंट एडजस्टिंग इवेंट. जाता हूँ क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 में. राइट, इन प्रिपेयरिंग द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स ऑफ लोटस लिमिटेड फॉर द ईयर एंडेड 31st मार्च 2010 यू केम अक्रॉस द फॉलोइंग इन्फॉर्मेशन फुल स्टॉप स्टेट विद रीजंस हाउ वुड यू डील विद दिस इन द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स. क्या बोल रहा है? In preparing the financial statements of Lotus Limited for the year ended 31st March 2010, you came across the following information. Kya hai bhai? The company invested rupees 50 lakhs in April 2010 in the acquisition of another company doing similar business, the negotiation of which has just started. Agar aap dhyan se dekho, April ke mahine mein company ne 50 lakh rupees invest kiya dusri company mein, wo negotiation abhi sirf start hue. Was this event was there on the balance sheet date? Answer is no. And because it's no, this becomes what type of event? This becomes non-adjusting event. This will become an example of what event? Non-adjusting event. Continue. Dekh lo apka ICA ka answer ek bar. Yeah, hona to ab disclose kar lo kahan pe? Director report mein. You can also write that this can be make a disclosure in मैनेजमेंट रिपोर्ट में होना है तो डिस्क्लोज कर लो. बट यू कैन नॉट शो इट एज एन व्हाट सर एसेट ऑन 31st ऑफ मार्च. ये सब नहीं दिखा पाओगे आप. राइट, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 9. कैशियर, शैल आई गो टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन? या क्वेश्चन नंबर 9. कैशियर ऑफ A1 लिमिटेड एम्बजल्ड कैश अमाउंटिंग टू 6 lakhs ड्यूरिंग मार्च 2012. हाउवर सेम कम टू द नोटिस ऑफ द कंपनी management during April 2012 only. Financial statement of the company is not yet approved by the board of directors of the company with the help of provisions of AS 4 contingencies and events occurring after the balance sheet date. Decide whether embezzlement of cash should be adjusted in the books of accounts for the year ended 31st March 2012. Will your answer what will be your reply if embezzlement of cash comes to the notice of the company's management only after approval of financial statements by the board of the company. तो यहाँ पे दो अलग अलग क्वेश्चन है. इफ यू ऑब्जर्व, एक तो है बिट नंबर 1, दो बिट्स हैं ए और बी. हम लोग केस बाई केस आंसर करेंगे. आई थिंक द फर्स्ट वाला जो बिट है वो तो रिपीट है. दिस इज सिमिलर टू विथ सम, यू नो आई टेल यू, दिस इज सिमिलर टू वॉट, दिस इज सिमिलर टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. ये जो बिट नंबर 1 है आप लोग लिख सकते हैं यहाँ पे, दिस इज सिमिलर टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. वाई क्वेश्चन नंबर 5? वाई बिकॉज एज ऑन 31st ऑफ मार्च व्हेन फिजिकल वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ कैश वुड हैव बीन डन. फिजिकल काउंट जब किया होगा, फिजिकल काउंटिंग ऑफ कैश एंड द बुक बैलेंस वुड नॉट हैव बीन टैलीड. देयर बाय द मैनेजमेंट इज अवेयर दैट देर इज अ कैश एम्बजलमेंट ऑन द डेट इटसेल्फ. राइट ना? देयर बाय दिस शुड बिकम व्हाट टाइप ऑफ इवेंट? दिस शुड बिकम एन एडजस्टिंग इवेंट. नाउ व्हाट इज योर डाउट? In a case if the books of accounts are already finalized and the company comes to knows the information, then this bit will be covered by what, you know, your AS 5. आप काम कर सकते हो इसको. आप क्या करोगे? You can show this as a loss of next year, but you should disclose this as what, you know, you should disclose this as prior period item. Now what is prior period item? Due to some error or omission in the past, if you want to bring any correction to an income or expense because of some error or omission, you have done some mistake in the past, you want to correct that mistake in the current year, you can easily correct that mistake in the current year by denoting that item as what? Prior period item. So by chance agar already books of accounts close ho chuke hain and if you want to bring the correction in the current year, you can do in the current year, but you should table them as what, sir? Prior period item. Right? To acha question hai, ek hi question mein AS 4 bhi test ho gaya, AS 5 bhi test ho gaya. राइट, तो फर्स्ट बिट का आंसर यही है, शुड मेक नेसेसरी एडजस्टमेंट. राइट, सेकेंड बिट का आंसर देख लेते हैं. सेकेंड बिट का आंसर यहाँ से, इफ एम्बेजलमेंट ऑफ कैश कम्स टू द नोटिस ऑफ द मैनेजमेंट ओनली आफ्टर अप्रूवल, देन द ट्रीटमेंट विल बी डन एज पर AS 5. being extraordinary item should be disclosed in the statement of what, sir? PNL account as a part of loss for the year ending 31st March 2013. That is, next year mein aapko loss ki tarah isko disclose karna padega. But you can label it as what, sir? Prior period item. I really don't agree that it can be taken as extraordinary item. It is taken as exceptional item. Because jab bhi business rahega, to obviously cash theft reh sakta hai. So extraordinary ki tarah dikhane ki badal se, it is better to disclose that what, you know? Exceptional item. As well as what, sir? We should disclose it as what, sir? Prior period item. उसको प्रायर पीरियड आइटम की तरह डिस्क्लोज कर दो, बेटर रहेगा. चलो, अच्छा क्वेश्चन है, बिकॉज एक ही क्वेश्चन में AS 4 भी टेस्ट हो गया और AS 5 भी टेस्ट हो गया, राइट? चलिए, मैं जाता हूँ क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 में. अभी क्वेश्चन नंबर टेन. नील लिमिटेड हैज़ इट्स कॉरपोरेट ऑफिस इन मुंबई एंड सेल इट्स प्रोडक्ट टू स्टॉकिस्ट ऑल ओवर इंडिया. ऑन 31st मार्च 2013 द कंपनी वॉन्ट टू रिकॉग्नाइज receipts of check bearing dated 31st March 2013 or before as checks in hand by reducing trade receivables. I think ye sam pehle bhi repeat ho chuka hai. The checks in hand is shown in the balance sheet as an item of cash and cash equivalent. The checks are presented to the bank in the month of April 2013 and are also realized in the same month in the normal course after depositing in the bank. State with reasons whether each of the following is an adjusting event and how this fact is to be disclosed by the company with reference to the relevant accounting standards. First, checks collected by the marketing personnel of the company from stockist on or before 31st of March. So question mein thoda variation leke aa gaye. Jo apne marketing employees hai na sir, wo marketing employees ne already check collect kar liya hai. Kab? On or before 31st of March. See, if the checks are already collected before 31st of March, then obviously this has to be recorded. This has to be recorded as what, sir? As collection of 12-13. That is, you can always say this is what event? Adjusting event. Kyun adjusting event? Because 31st March ko company ko already awareness hai ki marketing employees ke paas already checks aake baithe hain. Thereby the management should consider these checks as collection from whom, sir? Debtor. You can simply write the entry called cash and bank account debit to debtors. Right na? So in this case, whatever the management is following, it's good. Case badal de raha hai. Check sent by the stockist through courier on or before what, sir? 31st of March. See, if the checks are in transit, but they are not yet received by you on or before 31st of March, but are received by you before the books of accounts are finalized, right? Na? In that case, this will become what type of event? This will become non-adjusting event. Why non-adjusting event? Because answer is same. There was no such information on the balance sheet date. Thereby, you can disclose this as what non-adjusting event. Thereby, this checks collected should be shown as a collection in the month of what? April. Am I clear? So, agar question alag rahega, answer alag hai. Agar employees ke paas check aake baitha hai, right? Agar checks collect kar liya hai marketing employees ne, so it's an adjusting event. But in a case if the checks are not yet collected, they are in transit, and we are not aware of that information, then this becomes what, sir? Non-adjusting event, right? तो यू कैन सी द आंसर्स, एक बार देख लेते हैं. या चेक्स इन हैंड विल बी शोन इन द बैलेंस शीट एज कैश एंड कैश इक्वल. मतलब व्हाट आर द कंपनी इज फॉलोइंग इन द फर्स्ट केस, दैट्स अ राइट थिंग. सेकंड केस में क्या होगा? दिस बिकम्स व्हाट इवेंट? नॉन एडजस्टिंग इवेंट. मैं क्लियर? कोई डिस्क्लोजर करने की जरूरत नहीं मैनेजमेंट रिपोर्ट में. सो यहाँ पे दिया है, देखो, इट्स अ नॉन एडजस्टिंग इवेंट. A completely non-adjusting event, right? So I think you can write this is also what, you know, same question. I'll tell you which question. This is similar to question number 6. You can write here similar to question number 6. Likh do yahan pe, kaam ho jayega. This is similar to question number 6. Chalo aage ja raha hu main. Question number 11. State with reasons how the following events should be dealt within the financial statements of Pradeep Limited for the year ended 31st March 2013. Dekhte hain. An agreement to sell a land for rupees 30 lakhs to another company was entered into on 1st of March 2013. Ye agreement to sell already company enter ho chuki hai, right? The value of the land is shown at rupees 20 lakhs in the balance sheet as on 31st March 2012. तो यहाँ पे सेल वैल्यू हो गया कितना 30 लाख, बुक वैल्यू हो गया कितना 20 लाख, देर वे यू कैन बुक अ प्रॉफिट ऑफ हाउ मच यू नो यू कैन बुक अ प्रॉफिट ऑफ 10 लाख्स ऑन बिफोर 31st of March. नेक्स्ट हाउ वर द सेल डीड वॉज रजिस्टर्ड ओनली ऑन वॉट डेट सर, ओनली ऑन 15th April 2013. सी वंस द सेल डीड वंस द अग्रीमेंट फॉर सेल इज एंटर्ड बाई द कंपनी ऑब्वियसली द सेल इज ऑलमोस्ट कंप्लीट राइट. If the possession is already transferred and the deed is already entered, the sale is complete, the management should recognize this as what event? Adjusting event. Isko hum log sale ki tarah recognize kar lena better hai. Am I clear? Next. I think answer dekhna hai to aap log dekh sakte ho. The negotiation with another company for acquisition of business was started on 2nd February 2013. Pradeep Limited invested 40 lakhs on 12th April 2013. I think this is also a beautiful question. If you observe, the company is in the process of acquiring some other company, but the negotiations were in process on, and they started on what date? 2nd of February 2013. And when did the company made investment? Only on 12th April 2013, if I'm not wrong. As on 31st of March, there was no such confirmation with the company that we are going to invest in another company, right? Thereby, as there is no such information available on the balance sheet date, and subsequently on 12th of April you made an investment, this should become what event? You know, this should become non-adjusting event. Why non-adjusting event? Don't say sir negotiation to start ho gaya na. Negotiation start ho gaya, conclude kab honge wo bhi nahi pata, investment karenge nahi karenge wo bhi nahi pata. Thereby you can do one thing, you can show this as what event? Non-adjusting event, right? Dekh lo ek bar aap log, dono ke answers dekh lete hum log. फर्स्ट का आंसर है एडजस्टमेंट टू द सेल ऑफ एसेट इज नेसेसरी. सेकेंड का आंसर रहेगा नो एडजस्टमेंट टू एसेट्स एंड लायबिलिटीज रिक्वायर्ड. क्यों क्यों बोलते ऑन द बैलेंस शीट डेट देर वॉज नो सच इन्फॉर्मेशन अवेलेबल दट द नेगोसिएशन हैव कम टू एन एंड. ऐसा कोई कंक्लूजन नहीं था, सिचुएशन वॉज देयर बट देर वॉज नो सच कंक्लूजन. देर वे यू कैन रिकोगनाइज दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट इन द मंथ ऑफ वॉट यू नो अप्रैल ओनली. 31st मार्च की बैलेंस शीट में आप कुछ भी मत डिस्क्लोज करो. एम आई क्लियर? अगर कुछ डिस्क्लोज करना है देन यू कैन मेक अ डिस्क्लोजर वेयर इन BOD रिपोर्ट. अगर वो भी आपको अगर करना है तो डिस्क्लोजर यू कैन डू इट, अदरवाइज नो. राइट, वी आर गोइंग टू द लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ AS4. इन इट्स फाइनल अकाउंट्स फॉर द ईयर एंडेड 31st मार्च 2014, जेड लिमिटेड मेड अ प्रोविजन ऑफ 3% ऑफ इट्स टोटल डेटर्स. ऑन 10th मार्च 2014, अ डेटर ऑफ 5 लाख सफर्ड अ ह्यूज लॉस and become what sir? Insolvent. This information management was aware on what date sir? 10th of March. 10th of March ko hi management ko aware tha one of our debtor has become what sir? Insolvent. The loss was not insured. State giving reasons if the company may provide for full loss in its accounts for the year ended 31st March 2014. May nahi bolunga, main to bolunga company shall. So thereby the event is said to be what event? Adjusting event. Why adjusting event? Therefore, the company is advised to provide for what you know, 100% loss provide karna better rahega. Why? As on 31st of March, we have the information that one of our debtor has become what you know, bad debtor, and thereby it's better to book the loss, right na? So this becomes adjusting event as per what you know, accounting standard 4. Dekh lo, aap log ek bar answer. ये कंपनी शुड मेक वॉट सर फुल प्रोविजन ऑफ बैड डेट. पूरा प्रोविजन बना देना बेटर रहेगा. राइट, सो दीज आर योर प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन वॉट अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड 4. बहुत सिंपल सा स्टैंडर्ड है, राइट ना? सिंपल सा स्टैंडर्ड हो गया. और भी कुछ डाउट है तो आप मुझे पूछ सकते हो.